landing in your area once again. And today is International Pipe Smoking Day. And I'm on a trek. That's right. I'm on my way to a smoke shop in Miami, which is called the Smoke Shop. And they sell pipes, tobacco, cigars, and pens. So, a little bit of a traveling journey here. Nothing like a nice road trip to sort out the soul, the mind, and the body. So come with me as we go to the smoke shop. Smoke shop. How you doing? Here it is. Yep. How you doing there? Welcome back, YouTube. I'd like to show you a beautiful pipe that I purchased at the smoke shop. And I looked around at their pipe selection. They have a great pipe selection. They got Savinelli, they've got La Rocca, they've got, I think, Ascorti. I think there was even some Meerschaums in there. Didn't have a whole lot of time because I was kind of pushed for time. They got a beautiful lighter selection, a lot of Zippo, cool lighters, everything, tobacco. They've even got some jarred tobacco as well. And they had a Nording. They had some really nice Nording pipes that were marked down, and they were very nice. And I kind of wish I had more money. I would have bought more, but you know how the story goes, right? Anyway, I'll show you what I did get. I looked at the pipes for about a good 20 minutes to a half an hour. And since I have a decent selection of pipes, 30 or more, it took a little bit for something to catch my eye, and I'll show you what caught my eye. This really nice Rocca Barolo. And this is a beautiful, beautiful pipe. And you know, I'm a sucker for an orange stem, especially an orange swirled stem. Isn't that beautiful? Look at that stem. That is a beautiful pipe. Now, if you notice at the beginning of the, when we were walking into the store, you notice I cut the video short. That is because the fine gentleman who owns the store, Bill Singer, he's a great guy, great customer service. He would prefer, I asked him if it was okay to videotape, and he would prefer that we didn't. So I just got a quick shot of going into the store, and then I cut the camera. And he was a very nice gentleman, and he was nice enough to give me, he told me to go ahead and fill my pipe with some tobacco. So I went ahead and filled it with some, what else? Black Cavendish. So we're going to fire that up right now. I'm trying this pipe out for the first time. Very good. Very, very good tobacco. I'm not sure who actually made this tobacco. It was in a jar. But it's one of those better kept mysteries, right? To enjoy. Why should every mystery have to be revealed, right? Especially in this hobby. It leaves a lot to be desire. This is a great smoking pipe, I can tell already. It is absolutely wonderful. This is going to be really one of my best pipes. And you know me, like I said, I love orange stems. And I just can't get over that stem. Look at the beauty in that stem. Look at that. Isn't that wonderful? And the beautiful grain on this pipe. If you didn't get a better look at it before, you'll get one now. Like I said, it's a Rocca, I guess you call it, Barolo. Kind of a maybe billiard or pot shape. Having some tea with it, Lipton tea. Doesn't get any better than this, does it? It is a very nice smoke shop. I highly recommend you paying a visit to it. If you feel like driving to Tampa, if you don't, then don't. But I would say if you're like me, nearly 4 hours from there, 3 hours, 40 minutes, close enough, right? You might not want to just go there for the shop. You might want to plan the day out and do a few other things. So anyway, that video was shot on International Pipe Smoking Day. And I didn't get around to shooting the rest of the video till today, which is actually February 24th, because I've been busy. And as you notice, I'll be posting this video 4 days late, or maybe more than that. About 4 days late. But anyway, that's what I did on IPSD, International Pipe Smoking Day. When I first came on YouTube, I just want to throw this in there, and I did some pipe videos. I was watching a gentleman, Max Wolf Northwest, and he commented on this particular situation. He was talking about doing his first video and doing an introduction. When I first came on to YouTube, I have to apologize because I didn't actually make an official introduction of myself. I saw people doing pipe videos, so I just came on and I decided to do a tobacco or pipe smoking video, tobacco review. Maybe I can do that now. Take a few minutes. My name is Andrew. I am 54 years old. I lived 50 years, most of my life up in Jersey, most of my life so far to date. I don't know how long I'm going to live, but at this point, I spent most of my time living up in Jersey, in South Jersey, in the Pine Barrens, just outside of Atlantic City in Philadelphia, more like so down in the country area. It was a nice place to live for the time, but then I decided to come on down to Florida. And I used to, in my last days up there, the last 10 years, 9-10 years or so, I took care of my two elderly folks, and that was my job. I was a caregiver, and I took care of them. And as you've seen on my videos, my father is nearing the age of 100, and I'm hoping to celebrate his 100th birthday soon. But anyway, so we moved down here, me, my mother, and father. And I gave the house to my brother and let him take over the house. And I came down here, and that was in August 2014. And I had always smoked a pipe occasionally since 1996, but not really, like, you know, meticulously and not masterfully the way that I should have smoked the pipe. But it wasn't, you know, I'd smoke a pipe on Christmas, or I'd smoke it for a week or so, or a couple weeks during the Christmas holiday. I'd get some just chocolate blends or cream, Virginia cream, whatever, from my local tobacconist, which was Williams Totally Tobacco in Vineland, New Jersey, which is my hometown. And during the holidays, you know, whether it be Thanksgiving, Christmas, other holidays, I would, you know, smoke a pipe. So, or just occasionally during the summer, I'd sit out on my front porch at night, maybe smoke some nightcap. So that was an old favorite. But it wasn't until May of 2016. 86. Where'd I get that? Now we're going back 30 years ago. Never touched the pipe back then. Anyway, I came onto YouTube. I picked up my pipe again. And what inspired me to pick my pipe up again was a friend of mine from Mississippi. He said, I want to send you a couple of Missouri Meerschaum pipes. Have you ever had them? Have you ever smoked them? I said, no. So he sent me a couple of Missouri Meerschaums. And I let them sit around for a while, being as I was only a very occasionally pipe smoker guy. And what I did was I turned around and I eventually got to them and smoked them. And he also sent me a couple of Dr. Graybos. Now, I had a modest pipe collection of about 15 pipes already that I had collected, accumulated over since 96 onward to 2016. One really beautiful pipe, which I've showed you before, and that was this one, my Stanwall Freehand, Stanwall King Freehand. And that was my best pipe, and I had a Napoli, which I don't have in the room right now, which is in another room. I had this Stanwell here, which is a really beautiful pipe. It was a really high-end. These are a couple of high-end pipes I had. As well as, and I don't think it's here right now. Yes, it is here. As well as this one. And this one is, I believe, a Barling. A Barling pipe. This is a very beautiful red wood grain pipe. And this is really nice. I bought this, I think it was in 98. So, a lot of these pipes I purchased around in and around the late 90s. And I had a lot of other pipe, well, not a lot, but maybe another dozen or so. Cheaper, low-end pipes. One my uncle gave me, which I've yet to smoke, a Dr. Grabe. I'll have to take that out one day and smoke it. But anyway, I went back onto YouTube. I went back to the pipe smoking thing. And when I did, I smoked the Meerschaums, and he sent me two Grabos, and I got into it, you know, and I started going on YouTube and started watching pipe videos, and I discovered Matches 860. I discovered Mutton Chop Piper, which I learned almost everything, you know, from these guys. I mean, and they were the first guys I watched. I'm trying to think of the other ones' names. These were the early people, so stuffing things, you know, great tobacco review. So I went and I mastered the art. Well, I'm still attempting to master the art of pipe smoking, but I have dramatically accelerated into the area of meticulous and artistic pipe smoking. That's the only way I can describe it. So I figured I'd just give you a little bit of a late introduction there on my pipe journey. Since I've been back into this, I've probably purchased a good probably 20 or so pipes. And I purchased some nice pipes, including this one. And I have a Meerschaum Strombach. And I will show you my pipe collection one day and my lighter collection. But outside of that, I could just say happy International Pipe Smoking Day. Belated. And you all have a good one. And sit back, kick back, and smoke your pipe and your favorite beverage, whatever that may be, coffee, tea, beer, and enjoy yourself, man, because that's what it's all about. And this Cavendish is very good. So check it out, Smoke Shop, downtown Miami. It's at 130, I believe, Southeast 3rd Street. 130 Southeast 3rd Street, downtown Miami, Florida. And I will see you all in the next video. Cheers.